I shipped with a merc who had a gun like yours, Nyoka. He polished it, sang to it, slept with it. Not like that, as far as I know.
Sounds like he had himself a discerning palate. Where are you going with this?
You should know, you're getting excellent reviews from across the company. What can I do for you? You weren't supposed to look. I asked you to delete it. Oh, yes. No doubt someone else was having a laugh at my expense before you. This has been my albatross. The great shame of my career. I give MSI everything. My work, my youth, my left kidney, and for years, I was a joke to them. One of the executives required a transplant.
He's lucky they didn't want a liver or a heart.
I thought volunteering to donate might improve my prospects. Apparently not. In charge of a scrap heap of a city. Abandoned by the board and surviving only through the hypocrisy of our trading partners. I hadn't thought of it that way. But perhaps there's something to that. Thank you for that. Was there something else? Oh, yes. I'm going to be up all night with this. All those blanks waiting to be filled, boxes waiting to be ticked.
Try to control yourself, sir.
Have you any idea how powerful this is? Corporations have been toppled with less. What a question! Bureaucratic micromanagement is the only way anything gets done in Halcyon, and proper documentation is a key part of that. For our part, a bill of liquidation slash transfer form 52 will protect our holdings on Monarch by temporarily assigning them to a pass-through entity once we drop our bomb on the board. See, that doesn't even make sense. This is an electronic form. We don't need paperweights.
Hardly the point, sir.
I have reason to believe that one of the other corporations is operating on Monarch. Illegally and in secret.
Those bastards. Leave us to our perils, then come back just to reap what they can.
If we can find proof, I can use that as leverage to encourage certain powers that be to accept our Bolt 52 and reinstate us on the board. If someone is operating here, then Catherine's almost certainly supplying them out of Fallbrook. Perhaps she could be convinced to tell you where they are. That's part of the problem. She has certain ambitions for Stellar Bay, and I fear my asking her would give her the leverage she's been looking for.
Don't get yourself worked up, sir. It's perfectly natural to have a healthy fear of her.
We really don't need to discuss this now, Celia. Once you, subtly work out where this corporate facility might be, bring back proof of its operation. Maybe some nice letterhead. Or someone working there. That would do it. A foolproof plan if I ever heard one. I'll leave the execution to you.
Sounds like wrapped in here.
Oh, it does work.
Hey, Velma, I got your caffeinoid pills.
You're a lifesaver. Hope Abigail didn't give you a hard time.
Just the usual. Any word on Braxton?
Nothing. Don't know how much longer I can cover for him either. Give me those pills, will you?
Here you go. You know, you might consider a real night's sleep instead.
I'd give you a friendlier welcome, but I'm up to my elbows in salt tuna guts. That he's got his load on and I'm stuck covering his shift? That's... wow. I sure feel like an ass now. Yeah, I wouldn't wish that on Catherine herself. Still, it's good to know what happened to him. And that I ought to start looking for a replacement. Something else on your mind?
I wonder sometimes what they're doing on other colonies.
Uh-huh.
Think they're watching the same serials, following the same crossbar?
Thank you.
I never smell another raft, it'll be too soon.
Weren't you a sawbones? Figured you ought to have smelled worse.
Sure, but those things reek like bad cologne. It's different.
I'm with you there. At least humans have the courtesy to wait a while before they're bite. Like wrapped among the rocks.
Thank you.
me, Captain? Watch your feet. The sulfur pools don't just stink. They'll take a toe off.
Thank you.
nice and easy. Here we go. Nice one.
Well, hello, and welcome to the home of the Iconoclasts. I'm Rose. Please, take a pamphlet. In it, you'll find everything you need to know about Graham, his philosophist truths, and the Iconoclast way. He wrote it himself, you know. Oh, no, I'm so sorry. I keep forgetting. We're out of pamphlets. Gosh, blast it. Why, we're the only free people in Halcyon. No corporations, no shackles, no problems. I know, it's quite revolutionary. We're a community here. No jobs, no shifts, just people who help each other. You're welcome to stay with us, so long as you can earn your keep. The new boy! Yes, he's quite clever. He took to our teachings very quickly. Last I saw him, he was headed into one of the buildings up the hill.
I ought to mention, the Iconoclasts are loyal folk. Treat them right, they'll do the same. Turn on them, they'll open fire without a second thought.
Choice. It ain't the right choice. It's Spacer's choice. Bunch of garbage. Welcome to the Emporium. I'm Bronson. It ain't really a store. Think of me more like a quartermaster, and a chef, and a handyman, and whatever else we need. Oh, sure. Sulfur ain't so good on metals, and replacing parts is expensive. So we fix things till we can't. We gotta eat. Eating means hunting. Hunting means armaments. We used to let people take what they will, but then some idiot shot some other idiot over cards. So Zora set up a system. You fuck up, you don't get to buy gear. You play nice, you do.
Tastes like sulfur all the same.
Nuh-uh. Taro's got that sweet blood.
So? You gotta boil it or you'll get sick. Then all that sweetness takes to the air anyhow.
Nah, don't boil it.
Thank you.
Looks like I'm not the only new face around here. What do I call you, stranger? Welcome to Amber Heights, Captain. Call me Tucker. You here to join the Iconoclasts? Help us free this world? I am not a little boy. Haven't been one for decades, no matter what my mama wishes. I take it she's still looking for me? I'd hope she'd accept my decision. According to her, stepping foot outside of the house in broad daylight is too dangerous. My entire life, she crammed a fear of danger down my throat. Don't go play with friends. Mantasaurs will tear your arms off. Don't leave the city. Raptodons will spit acid on your face. Marauders can violate you. You'd fall in a sulfur pool. I stuck around way too long, ruled by her fears. I'm 42 years old, but she still sees me as a little boy in need of her protection. I won't stand for it, I tell you.
Show up with a bottle of vodka and some real good cusses. That'll show her how much you've grown.
Then she'll think they've brainwashed me into some kind of hooligan. As far as she's concerned, if I make any decision that's not aligned with hers, someone else convinced me. She doesn't want to see me as anything other than her baby boy. Why would I go back again? What'll be different this time? You're right. I can do this. I just need to stand my ground and make her see she can't control me anymore. No one can.
Never seen you before. Take my advice. Move on. Get off-world if you can. If you can't, get to the bay. I've been halfway around T1. Monarch, they call it now. Been around it twice. Stood at the hot pole and the cold. Nothing on this moon for nobody. There's a lot of heartbreak. Pretty simple, kid. I sit at the bar, I drink, I mind my own business. That's it. Whoever said that must have been lying. Maybe they was drunk. I don't know nothing a dozen better folk couldn't tell you. Look, you want to buy the drinks, I'll do my bit to keep you entertained. Just don't ask me to dance. I can't repay no kindnesses now. Alright, so I reckon one of the most interesting places I've been is the Hot Pole. You know what that is? Exactly. This moon ain't big enough to rotate. It's locked. One side always facing Olympus, the other always facing away. Olympus might not be a star, but it throws off ass loads of heat. Monarch's hot pole is the part that's closest to the gas giant. It's in the middle of this big mountain plateau. Volcanoes so high the peaks are in space. The funny thing is, then in the middle there's just smooth rock. Circular-like. All the dust blown away. Pale gray with hair fine cracks all over. I don't know what I was thinking. Maybe I was lightheaded from the O2. But I felt like I had to take off the breather for a moment, put my ear to the ground. I did get a burn on the low before I smartened up, put a towel under me. It was at the edge of hearing, deep down, far off, irregular. Tap, 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 tap. The sound of a bird pecking out of a shell. I don't like to tell that one sober. Get the shake something fierce. When there's a groundquake now, I hold my breath. Because I don't know if it's Olympus squeezing us for gravity, or wings getting stretched. A great many things. I'll tell you what. You want to listen to an old man ramble? Might be a job in it for you. I used to run with a squad of mercenaries here. Good folk. A fella named Lamont introduced me. Thing is, I ain't seen them in an age. Stands to reason they got themselves ate. Oh, sure. I was with them when the corpse were leaving Monarch. Hell of a time, that. We split ways around the time this twice-fucked moon got abandoned. Thing is, I got myself some fond memories. We had some keepsakes of ours we kept in a lockbox, and I've been thinking about seeing it found. I'll be glad for it, but I ain't stupid. This planet tends to get people killed. I just want some closure. Appreciate it, kid. I'll mark an outpost on your map. We spent a lot of time out there. Might be a good place to start. Here's a key for the door.
Right. How many good folk are we gonna lose to our missions?
That's just the way of it. We gotta earn our keep out.
A manta queen.
Yeah. We felled it, mind. But we lost 2 runners and 5 gun hands.
A total failure, then. So much for the ruins.
And hell only knows where the Van Oys are. They never showed.
I'm sure they're... Ah, let's talk later. It seems we have company.
Gonna need to buy myself an entire Rizzo plant after all this.
A stranger comes to our home. If you're looking for a path to walk, you've found one. If you're looking for a teacher, I am one. Welcome to the Iconoclasts. The truth that I have come to learn and embrace since shedding the corporate yoke. Out here, we survive by the sheer strength of our spirit. We have no need for the endless rules and red tape of a corporate structure.
We do seem to burn through endless ammunition and medical tape, though.
Yes, well, such is life. Our descendants will enjoy safety and luxury, but our generation is the foundation on which that future is built. Now, why have you come? A great many things, in fact.
We could always use a hand rounding up supplies.
Or... Now, here's an idea. There's an old printing press I've been trying to get up and running.
Yes.
We will make do, as we always have. Spreading the word of our movement is of paramount importance. Will you aid us in our cause? Wonderful. I requisitioned replacement rollers for it some time ago. Huxley should have delivered them yesterday. Speaking of which, where is Huxley?
You bought rollers? You haven't even cleared the wraps out yet. What are you doing wasting bits on... Forget it. Huxley's still recovering. She won't be up for a run for a while yet.
It seems we're out a runner. If you intend to help our cause, I'll ask you to meet our MSI supplier in her stead.
So you're her mysterious savior. She sings your praises.
That girl and her songs, so eager to learn, so bright-eyed, so tone-deaf. One of our sympathizers, a woman named Carlotta, periodically buys goods on our behalf from Stellar Bay's store. Stellar Bay has caught on, but they remain friendly, though the goods now come at a considerable markup. She meets us in the ruins of Bayside Terrace. From our compound, follow the road north. Wonderful. While you're at it, I wonder if Carlotta still has those high-capacity cartridges? Grab a few, will you? There should be some funds left over from the last shipment. We can use them to copy and modify radio serials. Yes, not just magazines, but their precious dramas.
Unbelievable. I hope I don't have to tell you this, but if there is extra money, would you mind buying, I don't know, food and medicine? Graham, if you need me, I'll be in triage. Sorry about earlier. Graham and I don't always see eye to eye. Besides, we just got our asses kicked in the ruins. Not a great time to yammer on about his printing press. Yeah, name's Zora. I've been patching up the Iconoclast since day one. Whenever Graham's lack of foresight gets someone hurt, I get them back on their feet. If I can.
After meeting that guy, I'm amazed anyone around here still has four functioning limbs.
Don't get me wrong. He's got an uncanny ability to harden folks' spirits, and we need that around here. That was a long time ago. Over in Cascadia. Rizzo was trying to sweeten up animal parts, and often that meant a lab coat got bit. Now I'm whatever I need to be to keep these folks from bleeding out. The Manta Queen showed up out of nowhere, and I guess the gunfire attracted raptodons. It was a damn bloodbath.
You found a queen that far north? Wish I'd been there.
You and me both, Nioka. We could have used the help. Listen, unless this is urgent, I need to oversee the wounded. You want to do us a favor or two? Go talk to Bronson. He's always looking to pass his work off on someone else. For now, I gotta get to the wounded. Welcome to Amber Heights.